Pokemon is a kid's game. I'm not doing Pokemon, because only little babies play Pokemon. Okay? So, screw all of you, I'm off. Go away, because I do not accept any- Ah well. Shit. Fucking hell. Pokemon. I think everybody's played Pokemon. And everybody loves Pokemon. Because what's not to love about Pokemon? It's a strategy game with a lot of depth. With a childlike theme. What more would you want? So, now I will list up my top 5 favorite and least favorite Pokemon in the Pokemon franchises. I will disclude Black and White because I've never played Black and White. Now, don't get me wrong, this is not going to be some list of top 5 best Pokemon and top 5 worst Pokemon. Because if I was going to go top 5 best Pokemon, I'd go on Serebii.net, click 100 top Pokemon, take the top 5, boom, that's the first part done. Right, let's go to the top 5 worst. Let's go all the way down the list, boom. Video's over. Have a nice day. Don't forget to subscribe. Let us commence with this video about my favorite and my least favorite Pokemon of all time.
Number 5.
I think it is a general rule of thumb that you cannot make a Pokemon list without including a legendary Pokemon. So which one will I take? They are nearly always in trios, and by far my favorite trio is the Weather Trio. And which one? I'm gonna have to say Kyogre. Kyogre? Kyogre? Kyogre-agary? Yeah, whatever. Why? I'm not actually so sure. I was young, it was my first Pokemon game, it was blue, I like blue. And I could not have done the league without it. I realize this is a very, very, very personal reason, but last time I checked the clock, this was my list. So now leave. Please don't leave.
Number 4.
And what's a list without a starter Pokemon? To be honest, I generally hate starting Pokemon, as blasphemous as that might sound. The first generation, the second one, only Meganium. The third, only Mudkip. And since then, the starters just seem to be becoming more and more like colorful blobs. Buy the new Pokemon! The Blob, Red and Blue. Now that we've narrowed it down to 2, which one is it? Meganium or Swampert? Well, because of the nostalgic value, Mudkip is slightly higher on the list than Meganium. And because of this.
Number 3.
Snorlax. First time I saw him, he was in my way. When you wake him up, he quote unquote attacks in a grumpy rage.
I can't believe you've done this.
What I love most about Snorlax is that he could not give less of a fuck. Not even slacking is comparable. He at least leans on his arm in that sexy pose.
Aw, yeah.
But here's a word of warning. Do not let his sleepy demeanor fool you. If you're not careful, he will jump up and whoop your ass. Literally, the only problem I have with him is the amount of time it takes to train him to level 100. He's one of those goddamn Pokemon that needs 1,250,000 experience points until he's level 100. It's just gonna have to piss me off.
Number 2.
By now, I have to admit that this list is very subjective. But the number 2 on my list is Ninjask. The reason why I love Ninjask so much is that it was the first Pokemon that I ever trained to level 100. Not that that was hard, I mean, it was a very easy Pokemon to train, needing less than half of what Snorlax needs. But on the objective side, first, it has Ninja in its name. Second, it's the fastest Pokemon that is not legendary.
I'm faster than you!
But we'll get to that. Third, it has a ghost counterpart called Shedinja.
Who you gonna call?
And they are both the only Pokemon that actually look good doing double team.
I'm the invisible man. I'm the invisible man. Incredible how you can see right through me.
Number 1. Number 1 is a bit of a no-brainer. It starts with Ray and ends with Quaz. That's right, you guessed it. The number 1 Pokemon on this list is indeed Magikarp. Why, I hear you ask? Well, isn't it obvious? Magikarp is a badass. Think about it. It is considered one of the weakest Pokemon alive, yet it is still the most encountered Pokemon. Now let's think of how many Magikarps there are. 1, 2, 1 million. And what do they all evolve into? Gyarados. 1 million Gyaradoses? Well, I'd rather not take my chances. But the real power lies in the actual Magikarp. Watch these examples of the true and pure might of Magikarp.
Number 5.
Arceus. He's a god. Not a god like Magikarp, no. The only god part of Arceus is in its Pokedex description. Let's see. Oh my god. No pun intended. It's Arceus, the biggest and baddest Pokemon of all. Arceus should have one attack and one attack only. Kill. But since it doesn't, it's on my top 5. Number 4. Oh, Pikachu. What can be said about Pikachu? Oh, I know. Fuck Pikachu. Pikachu is fucking overrated. Fine, it may be the poster boy of Pokemon. And fine, it may have the highest level of any Pokemon game. But all this does not excuse it from sucking. Yes, I will get a lot of hate for this. And yes, my rage is unjustified. But I swear, I cannot be the only one to think like this. I'm not trying to offend anybody, but why is Pikachu so popular? I just don't get it. Anyway, I do not wish to linger further on this topic. Let's head over to number 3.
Number 3.
Popular one, Burmy. But not for the reasons others give, such as it being ugly and that it's ugly. What the hell? Anyway, the reason why I hate Burmy is because I spent hours upon hours, upon hours, upon hours of time trying to get a female Burmy so I can evolve it into a Wormadam. Well, after about 6 hours of trying, wanna know what I got? 3 boxes full of male Burmys. That's it, I'm finished, I'm done, bye, I'm gone.
Number 2. Miltank.
Funnily enough, had you asked me a year ago, I probably would have put Miltank at number 2 or even 1. But there was something that changed my mind. But I'll get to the start of the story. Okay, remember the Goldenrod City Gym? Well, I still think to this day that Miltank is the hardest boss in Pokemon. That thing just kept getting healed and healing itself, and it just never died. So, me being the genius that I was, I decided to train my own. I trained it to level 87, and until then I was oblivious to the fact that it sucked. And Miltank is one of those 1.25 million experience Pokemon, so I was pretty pissed at about 3 days of my life gone. Although, I have to admit, it was kind of my own stupidity along with the game flat out lying to me that made me hate Miltank.
Number 1.
And here we are. Number 1. I hinted at it earlier on in the video. Can you guess? It's the one and only, Deoxys. What campers are to Call of Duty, Deoxys is to Pokemon. What pay-to-winners are to Team Fortress 2, Deoxys sensitive to Pokemon. And the worst part is, Deoxys' speed is the fastest Pokemon. Deoxys' attack is the strongest, but Deoxys' defense doesn't have the highest defense. Shuckle does. So this nearly perfect Pokemon, whose defense form is actually called defense, cannot stand up to whatever the hell... whatever animal Shuckle is supposed to represent. That's just sad and pathetic. And all the other forms of Deoxys are overpowered. And, well, that's just no fun. Well, that concludes our video. This was the first video I made with my new microphone. So I'd be grateful if you left some feedback about it in the comment section below.
Ah, well, unfortunately we've reached the end. Now, there are a few things that I would like you to do for me. The first thing is, tell me your most and least favorite Pokemon of all time. Any generation, even black and white, I just wonder what you're talking about. And, if you want to, give a reason why. The next thing is, please share this with everybody who you think could enjoy my stuff. Not with everybody, but with the people who you think could enjoy my stuff. Another thing is, thank you everybody who subscribed. It really means a lot to me if you subscribe. And I just thank you. And don't forget, when I get 1,000 subscribers, I'll be doing a giveaway. It's a long time away, I know, but when I get 1,000 subscribers, I'll be doing a giveaway. Now it's the compulsory things. Favorite, share, like, comment, rate. I said it. Now the compulsory things. Comment, share, favorite, subscribe. Here are my, here's my last review. Here's my last top 5. Here's my last review. Here's my last top 5. Last review. Here's my last top 5. And here's my last things you might not know.